Welcome to this new series, VR Camera in 2021, that you should know. In this series, we will talk about up and coming VR camera that will be released in 2021 by a working VR filmmaker. Here is a behind the scenes shuffle dance music video I just shot the past weekend with COVID-19 compliant supervisor on set. Don't worry, your boy is keeping safe while working hard for you, so you can get the latest VR experience with world-class DJ musician and dancers. But anyway, we will start with this series with a banger, a 12K 30 frame per second or 8K 60 frame per second VR 180 camera with two full frame sensor and 65mm IPD distance. It is the only VR camera that can max out the resolution of the brand new Oculus Quest 2 right here. Let's look at the official trailer together and see our reaction.
Okay, so I'm gonna watch this camera review. Let's see how it goes. FM360 Duo, full frame VR camera. Ooh, this is pretty. Okay. Oh, it zooms in. Look at that. It's like a whole different world with those flies. I don't know. Okay, what's gonna happen next? Let's see. I love this, the colors they have here. Oh my God, it's Mubong. Hugh, you should start a Mubong channel in 180.
No.
This gives me so many ideas. We could just eat salad, you know?
Gross.
We're healthy. We live in Venice Beach, so we gotta stay healthy. Oh my gosh, I really wanna hear her play this music. I can't even hear the music she's playing.
It's not about the music.
But I wanna hear the music. Okay, it's lightweight. I'll believe it when I see it. I'll believe it when I feel it. Okay, so they're doing some kind of vlog, live show. Maybe they're talking about handbags. Lame. Ooh, okay. We got a break dancer going. Oh, she thinks she's hot. Coming soon. Hugh thinks he's hot. He does. He thinks that. For sure.
I think of the camera, not the girls in the freaking video.
Whatever.
If you want to see me react to more VR camera product video commercial, like the upcoming install with your new camera, drop me a comment down below. All jokes aside, let's talk about what we learned from the video. The image quality is obviously really good, but why their demo has shallow depth of field in a VR video? I suspect the camera body is just like the Zcam K2 Pro right here. You can pop the original lens out and replace it with a cinema lens. I actually managed to get another video, which you're watching right now. It is shot on the FM360 AK broadcast camera. I translate that part for you. One good thing about your boy Hugh here is I understand Chinese, so I can read spec before everybody else. So this video is a demo of just one of those camera, and it is 8K. So the FN360 Duo is two 8K camera put together. Its IPD is 65mm, and if you are a stereoscopic expert, you know that is very important. The point is, the camera is as easy as the Insta360 Evo. It should have no stereo problem to make your eyes cross. Let's talk about sensor size, which is the most impressive feature of this camera. The sensor size is 65mm in width and 24mm in height, with 16 stops dynamic range. Put it into perspective, the brand new Sony A7S III sensor is 35.6 by 33.8 millimeter, so it is the exact same size. So we can make an educated guess that the FM360 Duo is using two Sony sensors that is also used in the latest Sony A7S III, which is really good news. This camera is going to be really good in low light, as we all know the A7S III has impressive low light, better than the Red Komodo. Another advantage compared to K2 Pro right here is the FM360 Duo has a built-in gyro. It used to calibrate stabilization in post. Why now it is very hard to move a professional VR 180 camera. With stabilization like the Insta360 Evo right here, we can finally feel some action VR 180 shot in professional level. In the image quality settings, you can set your color profile to Rec 709, HLG, HDR, and S-Log and S-Log 2. This is another evidence that FM360 Duo is using Sony Tech. If you don't know already, I have a system to evaluate VR camera, and it is explained in detail in my 360 VR filmmaking masterclass, link right here. And this video is based on this system. The next thing we need to pay attention to is the codecs and bitrate. The bitrate is 400 megabit per second and it is in H.265 Mate 10 profile with the ability to go 10 bit color depth. This is not so impressive in 2021. For a professional camera in these specs, it should offer ProRes in 422 color subsample, just like the K2 Pro right here. K2 Pro actually support ProRes HQ and RAW. I personally hate the 10-bit color in H.265. It really slowed down our post-production pipeline in both the Coolcam 8K or the Insta360 Titan. It is gimmicky. If any camera offer more than 10-bit color, it should be in ProRes or some kind of RAW format. So let's hope FGX, the maker of this camera, is listening and give us the ProRes feature when it releases. Let's talk about storage. It uses TF memory cards with optional support for external USB SSDs, which is really good. They learned this from the Blackmagic or the Techkey. Support SSD will save us lots of money in storage. This is not only a cinematic VR camera, but also a VR livestream broadcast level camera. It has built-in gigabit Ethernet ports. Judging from the product photo, it also has professional input and output and limo ports for a reliable power solution. VR 180 live streaming is not here in US yet. Only Facebook or Oculus Venue support 180 live stream, and it is not VR or definitely not in 8K. But good to know you are also investing in a professional VR live stream camera, as VR live stream is huge right now, especially during the pandemic. This camera will not need Mystica VR to do stereo calibration in post like the Zcam K2 Pro, which is a nightmare if you have experience in VR 180 post-production. Again, I have a course for that if you want to turn any DSLR, mirrorless camera, or even cinema camera like the Red Komodo into VR 180 rig. This camera will skip all that. Probably not good for my in-depth VR course, but it is good for you. One last thing to learn. This is all the information I have for you for now, and I can't wait to get my hand on this camera and start testing it in real world production, like what I did here with Shade. If you are new to the world of VR 180 and don't know why you want to make your music video, narrative film, or documentary in VR 180, I would highly recommend to go check out my new release here inside Oculus Quest 2. This is something you need to experience in VR to know its power. If you want to learn how to film in VR professionally, then you should check out my VR filmmaking masterclass right here. We will have a session dedicated to VR 180 filming. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to keep up to date. And I will see you next time. There you go. Derp.